Week six, okay. Week six. You guys are looking at week five currently. I've graded the quiz, and I have to say everybody did exceptionally well. I kind of wonder if maybe I should have made the quiz a little bit harder. No, I just think you guys are pretty good. So let's see. This week we're gonna look at we're gonna kind of start wrapping up things with office technology. So we're gonna kind of see the last bits of. So we're gonna kind of come up on the end of text editing software or word processing software, I should say, and spreadsheet software. We're gonna start in on more computery stuff. So like hardware, internet connections, you know, how to tell if you have a virus, maybe some internet security things, how to stay safe out there on the internet. I do want to say a few more things about the quiz and what we've covered. First of all, a couple of thoughts on the quiz. So part of the instructions for the quiz were to perform a set of actions using the Google Apps software. Now, the reason I picked this option was because it's a universal platform. It looks the same for everybody. Doesn't matter if you're on a Mac or a Linux system or a Windows system, it'll always look the same. If I were to use Word, Word on a Mac looks different than it does on Word on a PC. So what I would show you would not necessarily line up with what you are seeing. The other piece of that is, if you're using Word on a Windows system, I'm on a Mac, so when you send me those files, they may not display correctly, and I don't want to evaluate your work based on, you know, a mistake in the transition from Windows to a Macintosh, something that's beyond all of our control. So that was why I picked Google Docs from the beginning, because this way our experience will be the same, no matter, you know, no matter what platform we're on, it will be the same. So a couple people lost some points for using Word as opposed to using Google Docs, and this wasn't malicious. This was because, you know, it was part of the instructions, and so if that wasn't done properly, then things weren't displayed correctly. Another thing to mention is I don't always have access to a copy of Word, so if I'm given a file in a proprietary document format, I may not, well, I mean, I can open it in Google Docs, of course, but it doesn't necessarily render it the same way. So a lot of times, I say the chart that I had you include, it doesn't show up if it's sent in a document format and I have to upload it into Google Docs. I mean, it shows up most of the time, but sometimes it doesn't. And so another thought on that is I just wanted to mention that the Google Apps suite of tools is fully functional. I mean, it has every feature of a modern word processing or office piece of technology. It lacks some of the niceties and some of the bells and whistles, but it has everything that you could want. The only exception to that is mail merge, but we're going to talk about that a little bit. We're also going to look at a comparison of Google Docs, Word, Pages, which is the Macintosh iWork word processor, and there's a free open source Office suite called LibreOffice. We're also going to look at their offerings. I just kind of want you to see what's out there and see how it compares. The large difference between the Google Apps, being Google Docs, Sheets, Presentation, those things, and something like the Microsoft Office suite is that the main difference is things like Word and Pages, that's the iWork offering, and LibreOffice. They just have more options to do things. Like if you're going to insert a table, it'll let you insert it in a particular color, or you know, you can draw lines in a different way. But it's all things that you can do in Google Docs, and through this course, you've learned about these things. And since you know they're possible, you can look at something like Word or Pages and say, well, I know how to do this in Google Docs, so let me see how I can do it in this. And your knowledge from this class will allow you to use the tools that are available in Word and Pages to much greater effect. So basically, rather than having to rely on whatever Microsoft or Apple is giving you, you can actually say, well, this is what I know how to do. And it'll basically be much more effective in the long run. So this week we're going to look at a few more formulas. Primarily, I want to look at VLOOKUP and index and match. I've been talking about index and match off and on for a little while now. I want to really look at how they work so you can kind of get an idea of how you would use those. I'm not real crazy about VLOOKUP. It's touted as one of like the functions to use in an Excel or a spreadsheet, but honestly, it's pretty fast, and that's really the only place it wins out over index and match. But I feel like I should discuss it because, if anybody's talking to you about spreadsheets, they're going to know about VLOOKUP, and I want you to be prepared for that. Honestly, I don't know. I like index and match much better. I feel it's e they're easier to control and they give better results. I'm also going to talk about lynda.com. I don't know if you guys are aware of this. It's a computer training service. They offer training in everything from, using an iPad to creating PowerPoint presentations. Now, normally you have to pay for this service, but as students at Channel Islands, you get access to this for free. So while you're still a student, I would highly recommend taking advantage of this. And they have some really good, really in-depth videos on using PowerPoint to craft presentations. I feel like I haven't given you a lot of information on that because that's really a style thing, not really a technical thing, and this is more about technical stuff. Like I mentioned earlier, we're also going to do a comparison of Google Docs, Word, Pages, and LibreOffice, just so you can kind of see what those look like. You already really know how to use them. I just want to show you what they look like so you can kind of see, oh, well, this is where Word puts, tables, this is where page, the things you already know how to do, where those are located in these offerings. We're also going to look at a comparison of Excel, Numbers, that's the iWork offering, LibreOffice, and I mean, we've already seen so much of the Google Sheets that I don't think we're going to look at that. We'll also look at some basic computer hardware this week. Primarily, we're just going to look at the binary number system and memory versus storage. The reading this week, there's a book that you can get to from the Channel Islands website. It's on .NET programming, but the first chapter is actually a really good rundown on computer hardware. There's also another book through the Safari Online Books that talks about computer hardware completely. I found a how-to off of cnet.com that really covers the difference between storage and memory. It gets a little bit technical, but they have an audio file that's good to listen to. There's another article on memory and storage, and something from the math dude on quickanddirtytips.com on binary numbers.